biggest fight of a young man's career. And for Tony Ferguson, he hopes his 12th professional win will make him the new Ultimate Fighter. Interesting that Team Death Clutch, led by, of course, his head coach on the show, Brock Lesnar, personally invited him to come and train in Minnesota after the taping of the show. And truly, Tony Ferguson took it as the honor it was meant to be.
Well, having an opportunity to train not just with Brock Lesnar, but Brock Lesnar's trainers and the guys who work with him, huge, huge honor and an excellent opportunity for him. Tony Ferguson is in right now the biggest moment of his young life. It's all going down right here, and the stakes are very high.
大家好，老师从业中医男科30余年，帮助了数千名海内外华人朋友通过中药调理重回男性雄风。如果你也存在房事时间短、勃起无力、硬度差、中途疲软、肾虚、前列腺炎等问题，现在就加中医老师微信574-993-200，纯中药，一人一方，治根治本，帮助你持续坚挺20至40分钟，补肾壮阳，延时助勃，彻底告别快男软男。记住微信574-993-200。
The season, and it was Ferguson and Charlie Rader who were going after each other, and Tony said some things which basically turned him into public enemy number one of season 13. That said, Tony doesn't care. Tony wants to come and win tonight, show all the critics that he is worthy of the six-figure contract and a huge opportunity to fight inside the octagon here at the UFC level. Tony Ferguson. Missed the cut for the show on two occasions. The third time a charm as he made the field of the fighters competing at 170. And now he has a chance to become the Ultimate Fighter. Our tale of the tape for this, our main event of the evening, is brought to you by Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed for that great Pilsner taste. Taste greatness. Ferguson is 27. Nijem is 23. Ferguson will have a slight reach advantage. With the official introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight will determine who will be the Ultimate Fighter Season 13 winner, as this is the main event of the evening. Sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission, with Chairman Bill Brady, Executive Director Keith Kaiser, Commissioners in attendance, Francisco Aguilar, Skip Avancino, TJ Day, and Pat Lundball. Our three judges scoring this contest are Patricia Morse-Jarman, Glenn Trowbridge, and Saul D'Amato. And when the action begins, a referee in charge of the octagon, Josh Rosenthal. And now, live from the Pearl at the Palms in Las Vegas, it's time! Three rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a freestyle fighter holding a professional record, 11 wins, 2 losses. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 169 pounds. Fighting out of Ventura, California, Tony El Cucu. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a wrestler, holding a professional record, 5 wins, 1 loss. Standing 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Orem, Utah, Ramsey Nijem.
All right, gentlemen, we've been over your instructions. I expect a clean fight. Obey my commands all times, defend yourselves all times. Touch gloves, go back, let's do this.
It's Team Lesnar against Team Dos Santos. Tony Ferguson against Ramsey Nijem. The ultimate finale. Team Lesnar versus Team Dos Santos, Pearl at the Palms, Las Vegas, Nevada. Main event, here we go! Tonight's clock brought to you by Bad Teacher. In theaters, June 24th.
Ramsey moves right to him. And Tony ducks all those and gets the takedown. Ramsey fighting off his back, takes a couple of shots. Tony's on top.
Green trunks for Tony Ferguson, black for Ramsey Nijem.
And Tony inexplicably decided to put his leg inside of Ramsey's half guard. He was in a side control position, but I guess he felt like he didn't have full control of the body, so decided to give up that and push him down. Now he's on top in half guard.
Calling for the body head with the ground and pound.
Ramsey struggling to his feet. He's got a single. Let's see if he can complete it. Oh, look at this rollover. Oh, beautiful transition.
Good scramble. Looking to throw some punches while he's on his way up. Combination by Nijum. Ferguson has a leg. Ferguson showed a lot of head movement in his semifinal win over Chuck O'Neill and mixed up his striking very nicely. Also used the inside leg kick a ton in that fight. That said, Ramsey Nijum a bigger threat for a takedown.
Ramsey caught him with a little right hand there. But Tony's got some good head movement. It's hard to clip him cleanly.
Coming over the top was Nijum.
That was one of those wild Chuck Liddell style looping right hands.
Good lead left a couple of times by Ferguson. Both men trying to settle in and implement their game plan.
Oh,
right hand by Ferguson. Ramsey with a flurry of punches.
Ferguson showing some good wrestling, Mike. Much improved, and I think Ramsey might be a bit shocked.
Was raised in Michigan. He was a three-time Michigan High School All-State Honor Award recipient. Won the state championship his senior year. Two-time Collegiate All-American at Grand Valley State University in wrestling, Tony Ferguson. And that's the thing, Joe. We saw such dynamic striking on the show.
But you can see in that clip that they showed of him training that he's got great wrestling.
Yeah.
His movement is very good. Oh, Ramsey clipped him there.
And now Ramsey trying to put the strike attack on. Ramsey, a collegiate wrestler as well. Nijum, wrestling from 2006 to 2009 at Utah Valley University.
Ferguson's got a very solid jab, Mike. And you hear his corner calling out for it, and there it is again.
.115 on the clock, round one. Three-round fight for the honor of the Ultimate Fighter. Headshot, and it's all over! Tony Ferguson is the Ultimate Fighter! Fight replay brought to you by the United States Marine Corps. The few, the proud, the Marines.
He clipped him with that one. It's the left hook that really got him. And then he finished it up with that right hand. And Josh Rosenthal had seen enough. It was the left hook, though, Mike. Here it is again, right on the point of the chin. The legs go out. And El Kakui drops bombs.
There's the hook. And there's the right. That'll finish things. Josh Rosenthal stops this fight as Tony Ferguson wins by knockout to become the Ultimate Fighter.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Josh Rosenthal has called a stop to this contest at 3:54 of the very first round, declaring the winner by knockout. And the Ultimate Fighter, season 13 winner, Tony El Kukui Ferguson!
right, Tony, congratulations. You are the Ultimate Fighter. You win the six-figure contract. And
oh, man.
It's yours, buddy.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Look, Mom! That clutch.
All right, I'm here with the winner, Tony Ferguson. First of all, Tony, congratulations. Awesome fight. Awesome result. It's a long time in that house. It's a pressure cooker. It brings out the best and the worst of fighters. What was it like in there for you?
You know what? I learned a lot about myself in there. I kept a lot of stuff bottled up, and I brought a lot of inner demons with me inside there. But every single fight, what I did was I tried to fight them out. You know, leave it all out there. I got a lot of guardian angels upstairs that are looking after me, you know, and they make sure that I try to do the right thing. You know, from here on out, it's like I want to do the right thing, make a good example, set something up for these kids so that way they can look for me as a, you know, role model.
Well, let's take a look at the beautiful technique that you displayed in winning this season 13 of The Ultimate Fighter. You clipped him with this left hook, and that was the beginning of the end.
Holy crap, man. It's kind of like, I don't remember even throwing that. I know he got me a couple times, you know, but weathered the storm, you know, I knew that he was going to try to take me down. So, you know, just like BJ Penn and Fitch, you know, take him out of his own game.
Well, congratulations on an awesome performance. You are the Ultimate Fighter, and we'll see you again, my friend, Tony Ferguson, ladies and gentlemen.
Congratulations, Tony Ferguson.